Conjuring trailer. Let's do this. And fuck you, Tony Moran. What's up, guys? Finally, the Conjuring 3 trailer is out. What's this one called? The Devil Made Me Do It, okay? Going into this, I really like the first Conjuring. I think the second Conjuring's decent. It's good. I'm not a Conjuring fanatic. I love James Wan, which I don't think he directed this one. So we're going to look at this trailer. I'll break it down for you, let you know what I think of it. I'm excited, though. I'm excited. And this is coming on HBO Max, which is cool. This is the fourth video of four that I'm recording right now. I just finished Evil Dead, the original Evil Dead, Cruel Intentions, and I did Top 10 Sexiest Women in Horror. So look for those to come out directly after this. And I guess at the end, this whole Tony Moran dust up, I feel the need to speak out so that way I can get the message out as quick as possible that what this guy was doing at these conventions is not cool at all. So we'll get into that. I'll briefly give you my opinions. But anyway, let's do this trailer. Creepy.
Hey. You okay there?
Jesus.
Oh shit.
I think I hurt someone.
This is Ed Warren, here with Lorraine. All right, let's get started.
True case file.
Residents of Brookfield were shocked this afternoon by the broad daylight murder of Bruno Sauls.
The court accepts the existence of God every time a witness swears to tell the truth. I think it's about time they accept the existence of the devil.
Whatever is going on, whatever happened that day, that was not Arnie.
It's a witch's totem. We think your family was cursed. And that connection's still broken.
I'm only interested in reality.
But I can see things that your people can't. Something terrible happened here.
Master Satanist is not an adversary to be taken lightly.
She's doing it again. She's reaching out to the darkness.
Lorraine, you need to come back.
Is saving him worth everything you have? Because that's what it may very well cost.
And I'm sure none of that happened in real life, but that doesn't matter. It's Hollywood. Okay, I think it looks decent, like the first two movies. It could be amazing, or I don't know. And I think that's the point of the trailer. I don't think it's a trailer that really like leaped out at me, and you know, I got to see this immediately. It does kind of scare me that it looks like most of the movie takes place in the daytime, because if a lot of this movie took place at night, don't you think it would have been in the trailer? I don't know. Not that you can't have effective horror movies that take place in the daytime. I mean, The Shining, most of it was in the daytime. Or, you know, in a lit up environment, I guess. So, I don't know. I mean, we don't have Stanley Kubrick behind the camera. Wait, who's directing this thing? Hold on. Oh, Michael Chavez, who directed The Curse of La Llorona, which I wasn't the biggest fan of. Way too much CGI. So, maybe it's good that I'm going in with really low expectations, though, you know? It does seem like these movies always try to focus on Lorraine Warren, played by Vera Farmiga, which isn't a bad thing. Vera's a great actress. Elaine Warren's an interesting character, but, You know, you got to go into these movies with a grain of salt because it seems like most of the stuff is fabricated in these movies, and the Warrens probably never did any of this stuff. But that doesn't bother me. But they seem to always want to have some kind of anchor, and Elaine Warren always being that anchor. So I'll definitely see it, especially since it's coming to HBO Max, which is awesome. Now, I wasn't going to do a video on this, but I figured, you know what, I'll just put it right in here, okay? So you guys can get my thoughts on it. And it's not going to be that long, just a couple minutes. But Tony Moran, all right? I saw Dave McRae's video about Tony Moran. I knew that Tony Moran, of course, was the face of Michael Myers in Halloween. And I like that his face looked angelic, which, funny enough, Tony Moran in the interview that he had said, what the fuck about me looks angelic. You know, that's the way he says it. And little backstory, if you check out online, there is a video of Tony Moran saying some of the most disgusting, despicable things about, you know, fans of Halloween, about Halloween in general, even going as far as stating horrible things about Jamie Lee Curtis and John Carpenter with no proof whatsoever. And this is well over 40 years. But why even bring that stuff up some 40-something years after? And so there is a video that has kind of like a hodgepodge, you know, some clips from some of the worst, I guess, stuff that he said. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to give the guy the benefit of the doubt. I'm going to go watch the whole interview that's at one of these cons that he did. And the interview is like 50 minutes long. And I watched all of it. In his defense, I will say, like, up to a good portion, he kept constantly stating about Halloween being a piece of shit and why would anybody do this movie, and the only reason I did it was because of Donald Pleasance. And then he starts throwing dirt about Donald Pleasance. But in the back of my mind, I was like, there's something messed up with this guy. What's the reasoning? Why is he so bitter and angry about the thing? And then there's a point where he states that, you know, he was watching the movie in the theater with his girlfriend, and he said, this isn't that bad. So, up to that point in the interview, I was thinking, okay, so he's giving his state of mind before he eventually turned it around and was a halfway decent guy, you know, because we can do that. We can think the worst about something and then see it and then, you know, have a completely different point of view and be, you know, respectful about it. He did say that John Carpenter was a genius director. He didn't go out of his way to say Halloween was a great movie, but he did say as he was watching, he was like, this isn't that bad. So I can't like completely throw mud at the guy for that. But where it gets kind of nasty is just the way he treats the fans, you know, completely calling them losers. And why would you want my autograph? But then here was the kicker. This was the thing that really got me. He started talking about Sean Clark, and I don't know Sean Clark personally at all, okay? I know he has a channel here, but calling Sean Clark a cocksucker, and like, you don't call anybody that for any reason whatsoever. That's stuff that you don't say on the camera. And just, I mean, going out of his way to really just make Sean Clark look bad, but he didn't have any, like, evidence to make Sean Clark. He just called him a cocksucker. Like, what? And then he, you know, he calls Tyler Mane these horrible names, and he starts getting homophobic and offensive. And I just like, what is wrong with this guy? Like, why not appreciate your role in Halloween? And, you know, just leave it at that. You know, you came out of hiding after all these years. So why come out of hiding and just throw mud constantly? It's just a weird situation. And, you know, if you watch that 50-minute interview, he seems like a pretty successful guy. He said he was making like, you know, 20 grand a month doing, you know, mortgages. So why be such an asshole? Why be such a dick? So it's the first time where I felt if I saw that he was going to be at a convention, I would want nothing to do with the guy. You know, the only time I've ever had that happen, which is weird. It just to come out swinging at the fans like that, I think it's just disgusting. Disgusting. So anyway, that's my quick thoughts on Tony Moran. All right. So anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts on this Conjuring 3. Looking forward to hearing them. Be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day. And on Fridays, we do Fear for Fridays. Follow my Drum Dumbs on all my socials. Support me on Patreon. Buy me a coffee. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. And I really appreciate you guys.